Welcome dear students to another class of informatic practices. Today we are going to talk about slicing, that is one of the operation on list. So slicing is just an operation that allows us to create new list by taking out elements from an existing list. That means we are just taking a slice from a piece. Okay, in that way you can understand. So see here, we are having a list 1. So this is our list 1 that is having these existing elements: red, green, blue, cyan, magenta, yellow and black color. Okay, so what we are doing here is we are just slicing some elements from mentioned index. So here we are mentioning index 2 to 6. That means it is just taking out index 2 to 5 values from list 1. So 2 value is 0 is red, 1 is green, so 2 is blue. So it will take blue, cyan, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. And we want 5, so we will mention 6 here. So like this you can fetch. Okay, so till yellow it will fetch. Let us see it practically. So just see here on IDLE. So this is my IDLE. So here I am just implementing the same thing. So list 1, I am just mentioning this list 1. So I am just copy and pasting this list 1. And then we can check this out. Okay, so just do this thing. Or you can just type it also. For saving the time, I am just doing this thing. So you can also check by typing. It will be fine. Okay. So what I am writing here is list 1. And then I have to mention the indexing. 2 to 6 I am mentioning here. We will check 5 also. Index 5. So see, till yellow it is showing. So same result we are getting. And if we mention list 5, then it will give us values from index 2 to 4. Okay. So just see the result, how it will execute this one. So see magenta, so this is at 2 index, 3 and 4. So we have to give 1 index more here. Okay, so in this way we can fetch the elements, or we can just slice some elements from the existing list. Okay, so list 1 is truncated to the end of the list. So this is the list 1. And here we are writing 2 to 20. So 20 is out of index. So what it will do is it will start from 2 and it will go till the end. So here last element is, this is 1, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 magenta, 5 yellow and 6 is black. And it is 20, so it will go till the end, that is 6 black. So it will give you this as a result. We can test it, this also. On the IDLE, so see here, I am writing list 1 and then I am mentioning the indexing 20. So here you can see the result. See, till black it will show. Okay, so see here, if I will write some index that is higher, first index is higher than the 2, so the result will be empty string, because we are not having and values that is having these index in this way. Okay, so it will give an empty string. We can test this also here. So we can write like this: list 1 bracket 7 colon 2. 7 index we are not having right now, so it will give us an empty string. So this is the result, you can check. Okay, similarly you can also try on IDLE and you will find the same results. Okay, next we are having some more sequences given here. So you just check these sequences on IDLE, you will get the same results. So if we are not mentioning any starting index, then it will start from 0. So see here, list 1 blank colon 5, so it will start from 0. So it will fetch values from index 0 to 4. Okay, so see here, first index is missing, so it will take, consider it as a 0. And if we were slice, we want to give a step size, then we can give like this. This is start value, this is step value. Oh, sorry, this is start value, this is end value, 6 is end value, and 2 is the step size. So this also we can implement here. Just write like this and you will get the result. I'm writing here list 1, then start 0 I'm writing, colon 6 is the range, and then difference of 2 I want. So I can write like this. So see what result I'm getting is red, blue, magenta. So red is 0. Okay, and then I'm leaving a step size of 2. So this is 1, this is 2. Then it will take blue. These two it will left, and then it will take blue. And after blue, it will give us magenta. Blue and cyan will be lefted, and magenta we will get. So like this, you will get the result. It will go till 5 index because it is 0 to 6. Okay, so fifth one is, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till yellow. After magenta, it will not give you any value because these are the, we have given step size of 2. Okay, next is negative indexes. We can also give negative index. So element at the index minus 6, minus 5, 4, minus 3 are sliced. So like this we can write minus 6. Minus 6 means indexing will start from negative like this. Minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this way. Okay. So what we are writing is minus 6 to 2. So it will give you this value. You can test it here. So this is at minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, so we are writing this thing. So just copy and pasting this thing so that you can check the result. This is our ideally. See, green it is minus 6, then it is minus 6, then till minus 2. So 6, this is 5, this is 4, 3, and this is 2. Okay, sorry, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the reverse it will give till magenta. Okay, till here. Fine. Next is both first and last index missing. If you don't want to give first and last index, and you can directly give step size also like this, then it will just give you the values starting from 0 to last and with the step size of 2. Okay, see here, access list in reverse order. If you want to access list in reverse order, you can give minus 1, that let indexing will start from the right hand side and then it will go to the left hand side. So you will get this list as a result. So this is all about slicing. Okay, now next topic of R is traversing a list. Traversing means accessing the list. So we can access each element of the list or traverse a list using a for loop also. Directly we can access with indexes, and we can also use a loop for accessing each element from a list. For loop or while loop, we have not seen while loop in this 11th class, but there is another loop. So we will use for loop here in the 11th. Okay, 12th you will study this for loop also, and if time remains in 11th class, then I will teach you the while loop also. Okay, so see here, first is list traversal using for loop. So see here, we are having list 1, that is colored list. So for accessing each element sequentially, we can use this for is a, you can say, keyword. Item we have taken any variable, so it will test in this list 1. In is membership operator, so it will check that first thing I write, item is present in this list. If it is present, then it will print that particular item one by one in a sequential order. So this it will give us this result: red, then green, then blue, then yellow, and then black. And if no element will, after black there is no element, so it will terminate it. Okay, another way of accessing the element of the list is using range. Range function we have already seen. Range and length functions we can use, and we can access the elements. So see here, we are using here range function. Okay, length means it will give the length of the string. Okay, or total number of elements of a list 1, and range returns a sequence of numbers that starts from 0 and increase by 1 and ends at n minus 1, that is total number, and 1 less than the total number. Okay, so see here, we are having a variable I. I is any variable and it will check in the range, that is length of the string. So suppose length of the string is -5. So it will check value 1 indexing. 1, 2, 3 like this. Okay, so and then it will print those indexes values here. So see, first I value length is, in this we are having 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements. So length will be 5. Okay, so it will go in range 5.